familiar with Google Sheets.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I use it to track things like purchasing things, like planning out. If I know what I'm doing, I would have planned out and I would use a different sheet. So within one Google Sheet, you've got those tabs at the bottom. So I would use a different one for like each child.
Oh,
and then I would, and then I would have, say, columns that I would have, which I, you know, or, you know, say if you can have more than, if it's just one item, it's fine. But you can either use columns or just like list them, whatever, and put down the different subjects you're going to have and what curriculum you want. And you can start to like note things like what you have to purchase. And then you can have a checkbox as you do each one of them. I now have a whole thing like that, organizing my online classes, because I have to publish the modules ahead of time, and I have to go and check all the broken links, because that's the negative about having very techie. My online classes are very techie, and and so I have to check always before I publish. But I have little check boxes now, so I have all the lists of my classes, each module, and then I check my check boxes as I go through to see what I've done. So you have the same kind of thing where you can actually like have a little check box to make sure that you've, okay, you've bought this, and check it off. You can also, if you're using budgets, you can have a budget on the side there, and you can actually put in how much you've spent on each item. So you can see how are you doing. Yeah. So you can keep track of, you know, if you and your husband have decided we can spend $1,000 this year, and you sort of planned it out, you can see, oh gee, I'm running out. I think I'm going to have to use the library for some things. I better start looking through used curriculum or whatever else. But you can plan things so much better now. And because Sheets allows you to add very easily, you just, you can sum up and you can see that difference. And again, I use Google Sheets in a very limited fashion. I add things, I subtract things, and I put things down. And I use it all the time. I don't think the day goes by when I don't use it. And I'm not doing anything fancy. There are no fancy formulas. It's how I work out. I use teaching assistants in my classes to help me grade. And it's how I work out how much I owe them. I just keep track. Everybody has their own spreadsheet. And that's, you know, how I just do it and keep track as to when I paid them and put dates and things. It's just so easy to make columns. I, that's also how I do birthday gifts. Christmas, I have columns for each kid, and I have the approximate value so that I end up with knowing that I spent about the same on each child. And so that I also can remember who I've actually bought things for, because especially as it now starts to be spouses and things, it starts to get tricky. Right. So it's, but the other cool thing it's useful for is keeping track of what you do in your homeschool. Now you can keep grades. Now you could use something like Homeschool Tracker. I used, there was in my day a free version of Homeschool Tracker, and that's actually what I use. So you can use, you know, I know that that's one that, and I know that works. But you can get away with not spending anything and just doing it on Google Sheets, where you just keep track of the different grades and then you sum them together and you use that to keep track of how much they're doing. But you also need, especially when they get to high school, and you should encourage them to keep track of things like service hours. There are a number of scholarships that ask you how many hours. Well, you've got your youngest, so you must know this if you've been through the scholarship route. They want to know how many hours you've spent. Things like ELKS. ELKS needs to know all that kind of thing, the ELKS MVP scholarships. Then when you're applying for college, they will sometimes ask, you know, what did you do over the past summers? So you want to keep track of what they're doing, workshops they've attended, any sort of honors they've achieved. And believe me, you might think that that great thing they did in ninth grade, you'll never forget. I can remember sitting down with my oldest son, and we did 4-H. We did techie 4-H, very techie 4-H, but we did 4-H, and we used, and the umbrella school we used, because we're in a state to use umbrella schools if you want, they made us do a portfolio every year, which was the bane of our existence until we had to sit down and actually fill out those applications. Oh, and I remember he thought he'd put in everything he had, and then I was looking through, I think his 4-H one, and I'm like, your team came second or third at first Lego League at state. He's like, no, not that yet. I'm like, yeah, it's all, no. And he, I'm like, look, we have it all down. And he really thought it was the year before. He did not realize it was his ninth grade year. And I'm like, no, you actually guys did really well. And they won medal awards. And he was the main programmer of the robot. So it was something it did look good. And so we would never remember it. So you want to keep track when they hit ninth grade. Start to keep track of everything they do. And there again, if you have a shared spreadsheets that you're sharing with your child, either of you can update it. And obviously, you know, as they're getting older, you want to teach them responsibility, and they need to sort of keep track. And you can, again, they'd have different tabs, you know, one to keep track of, you know, their work hours, where they're working, another one to keep tab on volunteer things.
That's a great idea. Yeah. Just using the tabs for those different.
Yeah. I just like to use, and as I say, the tech I use is very easy to use. I'm not using fancy bells and whistles stuff, which is why I kind of wanted to share and show you, because you can use all these in a very fancy way, but I don't, and yet I find it extremely useful.